Hello, I'm Dr. Nick Vogelzang. I'm going to be commenting on the article entitled Effects of Tumor Burden Reduction on Survival in Epithelioid Malignant Pleural Mesothelioma. This paper will shortly be appearing in the Mayo Clinic Proceedings. This article is a late follow-up of a randomized phase 3 trial that has been probably the most heavily cited article in mesothelioma literature, namely the randomized phase 3 trial of cisplatin versus cisplatin-Alimta, which showed an improvement in overall survival with the doublet chemotherapy of cisplatin and pemetrexed, otherwise known as Alimta. In that article published in 2003, there was never a report of tumor regression. The reason that there was never a report of tumor regression was that there was discordance between the Lilly, at that time the sponsoring company of the research, and the FDA reviewer's report. So we did not report response. What Dr. Mansfield did, he's the first author of the paper, was to go back and look at the shrinkage of the tumor as an independent review. He did this using the original data from Lilly and analyzed this using the assistance of Dr. Peikert and Dr. Simonowski, the original statistician in the trial. What he showed, and which is, I think, an important contribution to the literature, is that if the chemotherapy shrinks the cancer, the patient lives significantly longer. Let me just look at the exact numbers here. What he showed was that the average survival of patients whose tumors shrink was 20.6 months versus those who did not have a tumor shrinkage was 9.4 months. And moreover, those patients whose tumors shrank had a longer time to disease progression, not just survival, but disease progression compared to non-responders. The difference there was about 8 months versus about 4 months. So we looked at a lot of different factors, but what was ultimately the result is published here is that when you give a mesothelioma patient chemotherapy, a doctor who is monitoring the cancer size by the CT scan can be fairly confident that if the tumor shrinks, the patient will live significantly longer. Now, there are flaws in that argument. The patient has to live a certain length of time in order for them to be assessed. But Dr. Simonowski, the biostatistician, corrected for those factors using a landmark analysis and showed that indeed a shrinkage of tumor is a major benefit to patients and a major predictor of longer life. This finding relates to clinical practice in two ways. Number one, it helps the doctor treating the patient know that there is a real benefit to the treatment. And secondly, it helps the patients because the patients can then know that the X-ray showing a shrinkage of the cancer is going to give them longer life, and they're then able to tolerate the chemotherapy side effects, which can be significant. And this then gives them confidence that a side effect profile, which is somewhat difficult, is worth the effort. From a patient perspective, the majority of patients, about 50%, just under 50%, about 47 or 48% of patients, will have a tumor shrinkage. Those patients who get tumor shrinkage will then feel good and will continue on the treatment. For those patients whose tumor does not shrink, they will be able to then turn their attention to a newer treatment option or other treatment options that were not available when this study was done almost 15 years ago. The next step for this line of research is that we need to find ways to improve the response rate. Now, there have been a large number of studies done looking at adding a drug to this two-drug combination. The pemetrexed cisplatin regimen has been long-term and long used and widely used. Many studies have tried to improve upon that two-drug regimen. Just recently, a study of an agent called nintedanib, a third drug, was added to the two-drug regimen, and sadly, that did not improve the outcome. Although it did improve the outcome in certain categories of patients, namely those with a high platelet count, a French and Spanish study showed that adding the drug bevacizumab or Avastin to the two-drug regimen improved the outcome. And therefore, if the patients can get bevacizumab added to the two-drug regimen, they may have a better outcome, but that is not always approved by the insurance companies. I think the paper is an important contribution to this large and long-standing debate as to how to treat mesothelioma. This is a rough disease for many patients, and it's a rare disease. There's only about 3,000 or 4,000 cases a year in the United States. And the few patients that get this disease each year always struggle with what to do. Should they take chemotherapy or should they not? And the answer really is they should take chemotherapy. It works. And when it works, it provides a significant improvement in overall life expectancy. Thank you.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.org. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.